Hey guys, what if I told you that you can speed up your renders by about 50%? Would you believe me? Well, what if I told you that after I show you how, you'll be able to do it in about 3 seconds? And the only requirement for this is that you have an NVIDIA card that is either in the 1000 series, the 2000, the 3000, or the 4000 series. So basically it's the Pascal, the Turing, the Ampere, the Lovelace or the Hopper, which are the H100 or the special ones. But if you have an NVIDIA card that's not older than, say, about 2016, this is most likely going to work for you. Why don't I just show it and you can do it for yourself? All right, so I'm inside Stable Diffusion now, and I've prepared a prompt that I just took from one of the prompt libraries. I'm going to set the sampling steps to 50 just so we can get up to speed properly. Going to leave the rest at default except the batch count, which is I'm going to set to 4, and I'm going to set the seed just so we're getting the same results in both our tests. Now we're going to run this without the fix. I'm going to show you the speed. So we have about 5 on our first, and then we're going to get up to 8.28 on our second one, and this should be around this value is where we're going to be. We're at 8.24 on our third one, and 8.28. So my 3080 gets me about 8.2, 8.3 iterations per second, which is, I mean, that's good. It's great. It's a good card, but we can do even better. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into our Stable Diffusion folder. You're going to open a notepad. Then you're going to take this web UI-user. Drag that into here, drop, and then at this line, set command line arguments. I'm going to add a space, double dash, and write xformers. Then you're going to save this, close. We're going to close this one, and we're going to restart our Stable Diffusion. Now, if you're doing this for the first time, you're going to get the message here that says installing xformers. And when that's done, you can see here, launching web UI with arguments xformers. And here again, applying xformers, cross attention optimization. So what this is basically a library that helps Stable Diffusion with some of the rendering. Let's see if we can just run this back without refreshing. Now remember, we had 8.3 as our highest number, if you round it up, 8.28 actually. But let's round up, let's go with 8.3. Let's press generate. We can see already our first one is reaching 5.48. The second one, we can see the 10 here. So we have 10.16. Probably going to get above 10 again, 10.12. And again, 10.17. So from 8.3 up to 10.17 or 10.2 if you round up again. Just by changing that, which is again basically a 3 second fix, you can increase your Stable Diffusion render speed. And the speed is a little dependent on what card you got. You can get a 5% increase, a 10%, or up to a 50% increase depending on your card. But either way, activate it. I hope this little trick is going to help speed up your renders. If you're testing this out, please check your results and put it in the comments how much faster your renders are and what graphics card you're on. And we can compare how much of an upgrade each card gets. If you like this little tidbit of information and want more of this stuff, you're gonna need to like and subscribe so the algorithm knows what you wanna see. Then my videos are gonna get shown more to you. Thanks for tuning in. Have a good one. See ya.